doctor who treats the diseases related to teeth and gums. What do you mean by crocodile? It's a semi-aquatic animal. It lives both on land and water. This is a poem written by a poet called Roald Dahl. So, we'll see about Roald Dahl now. The poet Roald Dahl was born in the year 1916 to the Norwegian parents. He began his writing career in fiction and non-fiction for adults. He published 9 short story collections, 2 novels and other screenplays. Dahl was awarded the Mystery Writers of America's Edgar Award 3 times. His 19 books for children include James and the Giant Peach, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory and so on, which won the Children's Book Award from Federation of Children's Group Book Group. Dahl died in the year 1990 at a hospital in Oxford of a rare blood disorder. He was at the age of 74 when he died. So this was about Roald Dahl, poet Roald Dahl. This poem is a fiction poem, that is nothing but imaginary poem. So, the dentist and the crocodile. Do you know, children, the amazing fact about crocodile? A crocodile has about 80 teeth. Total teeth are 80. The teeth keep falling. As you know, the teeth keep falling and get replaced. In the same way, it happens in crocodile as well. The teeth keep falling and get replaced. But how many times it happens in the lifespan? 50 times. So, 80 teeth, total teeth are 80. They will fall and they will be replaced. But how many times? In human being, it will be only once. But whereas in crocodile, it takes 50 times. It will be replaced during the lifetime. So, this was the amazing fact about crocodile. Let's see the poem now. Children, please open page number 27 of your Sunshine. So, let's read it. Unit 3, the dentist and the crocodile. The crocodile with a cunning smile sat in the dentist's chair. So what happens? The crocodile entered in the dentist clinic and he sat on the dentist's chair. He started with a cunning smile. Cunning is sly or deceitful, artful manner. He smiled and sat on the dentist's chair. He said, right here and everywhere my teeth require repair. Why you go to the dentist, children? If you have the teeth, when you are not well, when your teeth gets decayed, when it starts paining, what you do? You concern a doctor. The doctor who treats about the teeth and gums is called dentist. You go near the dentist. So here the dentist, the crocodile went to the dentist and he said, right here and everywhere, my teeth require repair. The dentist's face was turning white. Did you ever see a crocodile in a dentist chair, on the dentist chair? No. So when the dentist saw, his face was turning white. He quivered, quacked and shook. He started shivering by seeing the crocodile on his chair. He muttered. Muttered means, say something in a low and audible voice. Saying something in a low voice, that is called muttering. He muttered, I suppose I'm going to have to take a look. So he's saying, I should take a look of your teeth now. I want you, crocodile declared, to do the back ones first. Why did the crocodile say to the dentist to check the back one teeth first? Because the crocodile wanted the dentist to put his head and face halfway inside the mouth, huge mouth of a crocodile. Why he said it that way? Because he can eat him up easily. So the crocodile declared that the treatment should be done of the back ones first. The back ones. You know the 4 different types of teeth, children. They are incisors, canines, premolars, and molars. Incisors are the front teeth, 8 front teeth, which are in the center. Canines are the back ones. Premolars are used for the animals use this for tearing of flesh eating, for flesh eating, the harder ones. And the last one are the molars, which are the largest teeth. So the crocodile is saying to treat the back ones first, that is molars. to be feared. As he was very much feared, when the crocodile opened his mouth, so many teeth were there, so it was a fearsome sight for the dentist. So he was very much feared, and he was crying. So crocodile opened his mouth. He opened his wide, massive jaws. It was a fearsome sight. The dentist kept himself well clear that I should not go near to him. He stood 2 yards away. So, when the crocodile opened his massive jaws, all, how many teeth were there? 300 pointed teeth, and all are sharp and shining white. So he decided that, the dentist decided to keep himself away from the crocodile. So how much far he was? We'll see. He stood 2 yards away. 1 yard is nothing but 3 feet, children. If you measure in meters, it will be 0.93 meters. So not 93, it's 91. It's 91 meter. He stood 2 yards away. 2 is a number, multiply it with 6 feet, that is nothing but 1.8 meters. So he stood 2 yards away from the crocodile. The dentist keeps himself well clear. Before only he got to know that if he is saying to check my molar teeth first. So he was quite clear that if I check the molars, if I put my head inside, he can probably eat me. So he was already decided not to go near the crocodile. So he stood 2 yards away. He chose the longest probe. He had to search out the decay. Probe is nothing but a blunt surgical instrument. It's a long, thin and long instrument which is blunted at that, which is not sharp at one side. So he used that probe to see the decay. Decay means when the teeth began to rot, when the teeth becomes black, that is called decay. I said to do the back ones first. The crocodile called out, "You are much too far away, dear sir, to see what you are about." So I said to check the back ones first. If you stand 2 yards away from me, you can't see them properly. So he is saying to come closer. To do the back ones properly, you have got to put your head. So he is saying, I said you to do the back ones first, so you have to come closer to me. I have to put your head in my huge mouth so that it will be clear for you to check. Deep down inside my great big mouth, the grinning croaky said. Grinning means smiling broadly. The crocodile, the croaky means crocodile. He was smiling and saying to put his face and head halfway inside his mouth. The poor old dentist wrung his hands. Wrung means squeezed one's hand nervously, twisting his hands. The poor old dentist twisted hands and weeping in despair. Weeping means he was crying and he was feeling very hopelessness because he did not ever see the crocodile on the dentist chair, and it is saying to check the teeth and that too back ones first, that is molar teeth first. So he was crying and he was feeling very hopelessly. He cried, "No, no." Who is crying here? The dentist is crying that, "No, no, I see them all extremely well from here. I don't wanna come near to you. With the help of probe, I can see the teeth, molar teeth, very clearly, extremely well. I can see the teeth." Just then, in burst a lady come very fast in the day clinic where the dentist sat. So she posted there, and what she said? She was wearing a golden chain in her hands. Just then, in burst a lady in her hands a golden chain. She cried, she shouted, "Oh croc, you naughty boy, you are playing tricks again. So you have become too naughty nowadays. Don't play the tricks. Again you have started playing the tricks here. Watch out," the dentist shrieked. Means he was crying and he started climbing up the wall. "He's after me, he's after you, he's going to eat us all. Don't be a twit." Twit means a silly person. The lady is saying to the dentist, "You don't be silly," the lady said. and flashed a gorgeous smile and gave a dazzling, beautiful smile to the dentist. He is Hamlet. He is my little pet. So, he is my pet. You know, children, you got pet animals in your home like dogs, cats. But this lady was having a pet that is crocodile. And she is saying to the dentist that you don't be silly. You don't be a twit. You don't be a silly person. It's my pet. It won't harm you. He is harmless. He is my little pet. My lovely crocodile. I hope, children, you understood this poem, that is The Dentist.